guys, welcome back to my channel. Today my name is Tosin, and in today's video I'm going to be talking about exfoliation. Like I said in the video I made last before this one, I said I was going to start a skincare series on the vlog on the channel where I take you through basics of skincare and how to have great skin. So today's video, like I said, is about exfoliation. What is exfoliation, types of exfoliants, why you need it, and all that jazz. So grab yourself a cup of coffee, grab yourself a cup of anything you like, Fanta, Coke, whatever it is, and if it's full, if you are your father rice type and stuff, grab it and let's get. So let's get started. What is exfoliation? Now I'm going to explain briefly how this works. Your skin sheds. Yeah, was that scary? I don't know. But your skin cells shed, and as they shed, they have nowhere to go, so they are just there, staying there on your face or on your skin, and you need to take them away. Like, they are dead skin cells, you need them off your face so that your skin can breathe, so that the skincare products you use can penetrate into your skin and work well. When you don't exfoliate, most of the products that you're using are not working because there's no space for them to enter inside the skin. Now there is more biological jazz to all of this. I'm just trying to make it as simple and say it in layman's language as so that you guys can understand as easy as possible. Your skin sheds, your skin cells shed, and you have to help your skin to shed them away, like away. They cannot just shed and be lying down on the skin. You have to shed them away from the skin so that the products that you are using can work. Now, this is not bleaching. This is not scrubbing your skin away. This is not, I was black like Fanta, like Coke before, and now I want to exfoliate myself to look like Fanta. No, this is not what it is. This is just helping the normal process of the skin, natural process of the skin. Now, there are two types of exfoliation. There is physical exfoliation and there's chemical exfoliation. This should be my thumbnail. Okay, so I'm going to talk about physical exfoliation first. So physical exfoliation is when you are applying some level of physical force on the skin in order to shed the dead cells away. That is what physical exfoliation is in layman's English. So there are different types of physical exfoliation. If you see me looking, I'm looking at my board because I've written some things down so I don't forget. So there are some physical exfoliation that you can do at home, and there are some that you can't do yourself. You have to go to a spa, to an esthetician to help you do it. So the physical ones that you can do at home, the most common one are scrubs. Now, scrubs are the most common form of physical exfoliation, and scrubs are really tricky because lots and most of the scrubs in the markets right now are too harsh for your skin. The skin, especially the skin on your face, is extremely delicate. So the ingredients like sugar, you know, when you watch all those YouTube or Instagram video and they tell you that you should sprinkle some sugar on or some wewe on lemon and use it to scrub your face, it's not good, it's not true. You are destroying your skin. Those stuff are too harsh. Sugar is too harsh for your skin. Salt is too harsh for your skin. Gari, I've seen this one. I have seen it. I'm not going to call the person's name and I'm not going to put the video, but I have seen a video on Instagram where somebody is actually using gari to scrub her face. I don't know if they are trying to scrub their sins away, but I mean, Jesus already came for that, so I don't know why we're wasting our time. But anyways, you can use scrubs, but you have to be careful of the texture of the kind of scrubs that you are using, and you have to be careful of the pressure, the amount of force or pressure that you are using to rub the scrub. Now, look at the texture of the scrub that you are using. You want to make sure that the particles are very fine, like when you rub it on your skin, it's almost as if you are rubbing a normal facial cleanser. So you have to be careful about the particles don't go for large particles that are like sand. You don't need that, and that is the reason why there are a lot of people raising eyebrows on Kylie's skin, because she brought out a walnut scrub. Walnut, there is no way you can process walnuts that it can be as fine as the kind of scrub that is recommended should be as fine as, if that makes sense. I hope I'm not saying nonsense. But anyway, that's the most common form of physical exfoliant. The next most common form is or are spin brushes. Spin brushes. This kind of brushes usually they have batteries that you put in them, and then you switch it on and you put your whatever you want to put here, and then you use it on your skin. It is also a manual or a physical exfoliant, and a lot of people use it. I don't use it anymore. This is old. I had to bring it out from, you know, inside the box and comb that I put it. I don't use this anymore because I have read and I have actually seen and tested that it's actually too harsh for the skin, so I don't use it anymore, but a lot of people do use it. Another form of physical exfoliant are the use of towels or this kind of sponges. Okay, so these are face sponges. This one, when you put it in water, it becomes softer, but even as soft as it is, it still exfoliates your skin. This is quite better to use than spin brushes because it's gentle, not exactly gentle, but it is better than spin brushes. So yeah, you can use this, and usually you are advised to exfoliate just about once a week, if you are, or like once or twice a week or three times, depending on your skin type, depending on your skin context, depending on a whole lot of things. All that I cannot explain in this video, except you get a one-on-one consultation with an esthetician or someone great in skincare to explain all of that to you. Now let's move over to some kind of physical exfoliation that you cannot do in the house. Number one is a level of microdermabrasion. It's a type of physical exfoliation that's usually done by estheticians. There are some that you can do in your house, but the high-grade ones, you can't do them yourself. Also, dermaplaning is another physical exfoliation that you cannot do in your house. You can only do it at a spa from a licensed esthetician. Don't go and meet someone Yaromoke under bridge Ikeja for them to do them a play for you before they bring out knife and sword to scrape your face. Hey, well, please be careful where you take your face to. Please be careful who is treating your skin. Anyways, microdermabrasion, dermaplaning, etc, etc. There are also chemical peels. There are some grades of chemical peels that you can do in your house by yourself. But if you are new to skincare, please don't try it. And there are some that you have to go to esthetician, to the spa, for them to do it for you. Now, the best way of exfoliating that is advised is my next point, chemical exfoliation. So what is chemical exfoliation? Chemical exfoliation is when you use chemicals or acids as your exfoliants instead of the one you have to manually do, like scrubs, like spin brushes, etc, etc, etc. So when it comes to acids or when it comes to chemical exfoliation, there are three most common classes of chemical exfoliants. So let me break that down. Chemical exfoliation is the process of using chemicals to exfoliate your skin. Exfoliate there is the verb, the act of exfoliating your skin. The act of removing dead skin cells from your skin is called exfoliate. Verb, exfoliating, present continuous. Ha, more good, more beg. Now, exfoliant is the thing that you are using to exfoliate. So exfoliants are the acids. They are the things that you are using to take off dead skin cells from your skin. Shoye, do you understand? If you understand, give me a comment in the comment section. Give me a thumbs up. Give this video a thumbs up. Tell me, try. I'm trying so you can understand this thing in layman language, you know, you understand. So let's move to chemical. These are chemical exfoliants. This is this, I just almost finished. In fact, what is remaining? The cannot last one night. This is the mandelic acid 5% skin prep water from Wish Trend. This is the lactic acid 10% plus HA, hyaluronic acid, from The Ordinary. This costs less than $10. This is about maybe about $20-$25. Okay, they are both great, but they are not of the same great kind of. Let me explain. So when you are new to skincare, or when you are new to acids, you just want to introduce your skin to acid, because yes, the acids, they are great for your skin, but at the same time you want to be cautious. You don't want to somebody that you that you have been using Amina Salamin black soap before, now you want to graduate, you're not going to carry 20% acid and put it on your face. You will burn. What do you know? Yeah, you will don't know why. Like what you will burn, like suya, yeah, like roasted beef, you will burn. But anyways, if you are new to skincare, I always in fact it's not just me, generally it is advice that you start with the lowest strength of acids in the market, and it's usually 5%. Some are like 2%, but for acids, for active acids, usually go for 5%. Now this is the mandelic acid 5%, and it was awesome. Like, this is what I used to start my chemical. Okay, no, I started with some others, but this was like the basic, when I the basic, like I used all my chest to enter the chemical exfoliation gang. This was it. So please, if you are starting skincare, if you are starting your journey into using acids, please don't go above 5%. When you are done using that 5%, then you graduate. If there's a 7% of that acid, you go for it. If there's a 10% of that acid, you go for it. You graduate like that. Don't just start with 20%. Same goes for vitamin C. If you want to use ascorbic acid, that is vitamin C. You start small, start with 5%, you're 7%, then you go to 10%, that kind of thing. Don't start with 20% or 30%. Chemical exfoliants, there are three basic classes of chemical exfoliants. There is the AHA, there is the BHA, and there is the PHA. AHA stands for, I don't want to bite myself, so English is not my mother tongue, all right? So AHAs are alpha hydroxy acids. Hydroxy acid. Ah, I know when your boy is hard. English is hard. Are derived from plants, from sugar cane, from sugar, from nuts, from milk. Are derived from sugar, but they are not sugar. I did not say you should go and buy St. Louis sugar now, or you should go and buy sugar 15 naira from Malam and be rubbing it in your face. It's not the same as side, it's a jaw. Don't come and arrest me. I didn't say that. AHAs are attracted to water and they break the bonds in between your cells. So they break the bonds in between the dead oporoko cell that has died and the living water has carbonated, and the origin, the new fresh skin that is coming out. So that's why they are great for exfoliation, because they break the bonds between the skin cells. So most of the common exfoliants are under AHAs actually. So this mandelic acid 5% I showed you before is an AHA. This is lactic acid, lactic derived from milk. This is lactic acid 10%, and it is also an AHA. They are great for exfoliating your skin. Mandelic acid, lactic acid, there's a very common one, glycolic acid. If you are new to skincare, I would advise you to start from mandelic acid and lactic acid before you go into glycolic acid, because you can try it, but these are more gentlest acids than glycolic one. So than the glycolic one, they are also great for brightening your skin. I said brightening, I did not say bleaching, all right? Brightening your skin. When you take off old skin cells, the new skin cells that are coming out will reveal your true color, the color that you would have had if we're not living in Nigeria. If you were living in UK, US, the kind of color that you would have had. Yeah, they will bring out your true identity, your true color. BHAs are beta hydroxy acids, and the perfect example for BHAs is salicylic acid. Salicylic acid is best for you if you have acne or if you have acne prone skin. Salicylic acid is perfect for you because it penetrates into the skin and it deals with all the sebum. Sebum is oil. All the sebum in your skin, the excess oil in your skin, and it deals with. And then we move to the last one, which are PHAs. PHAs are polyhydroxy acids. As common in the beauty industry, like AHAs and BHAs, we hear all those every day. But PHAs are like AHAs, but they are larger. You know, chemical, when you look at under the microscope, they are larger in molecular size than the AHAs. So if you have sensitive skin and you don't want to dive into AHAs, you can start with PHAs. But like I said, they are not as common in the beauty industry like AHAs. So just, is our advice to go for the gentle AHAs like lactic acid and mandelic acid. Classes of AHAs, BHAs, PHAs for chemical exfoliants. If you still like to use scrubs, like I said earlier, go for scrubs with very, very, very fine particles or beads in them. Be sure that it's not the kind that will cause micro tears in your skin, because you may not see it now, but in the long run it's terrible, it's bad for your skin. However, I would advise that you come on board, come and train on the chemical exfoliation train, you know, join the gang, let's all glow together. This glow, you will glow different when you start using chemical exfoliants. And like I said, if you are new, start with 5%, start with once a week, then start graduating little by little, maybe once a week for the first 2 to 3 weeks, then you move to twice a week. Don't go above twice a week if you are starting out. Then maybe when your skin is now bulletproof, it's not like the road to Onoba, then you can increase to 10%, or you can still stick to your 5%, but now increase to 3 times a week. But space it out. Don't do chemical experiment on Monday, chemical experiment on Tuesday, chemical experiment on Wednesday, because there's actually something known as over exfoliation. That means OT, you have scrubbed all the skin off. Important skin, to need OT scrub a more dead one. Don't over exfoliate. Be very careful, don't over exfoliate. Another thing is, if you're exfoliating, please, I beg you, do not skip sunscreen, because chemical exfoliants make your skin more sensitive to the sun. Most of you are advised to use chemical exfoliants in the night before you sleep, in the night as part of your routine. But the next morning when you wake up, as you are leaving your house, make sure you use sunscreen, because your skin is now more sensitive to the sun because of the chemical exfoliant. And you have to make sure that you are moisturizing your skin, because as dead skin is going off, you still have to moisturize and protect the new skin that is coming out. And if you are battling hyperpigmentation, dark spots, get on the chemical exfoliation train. If you have acne, active acne, throw away your scrubs and get on the chemical exfoliation train. It will really, really, really change your skincare game. So I don't miss up about you in this video. Moti rojoku. Ah, I don't know me. Anyways, thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned a thing or two. I hope you enjoyed this video. Share this video. Let more people know and understand what exfoliation is and why it is important. Let me know other skincare concerns that you might have in the comment section so that I can discuss them in my next videos. Thank you so much for watching, and please don't forget to check out other videos. You know, I'm going to drop a playlist. But yeah. Check them out. Check some of my videos out and share. Thank you so much for watching. Remember that you are amazing, and don't forget to wash your freaking face. Thank you so much. Bye.